We all know the joy, colour and noise that is Brighton and Hove Pride, but little is known about its modest beginnings. LGBTQ+ charity Sussex Beacon hopes to showcase those beginnings with its unique display of newly discovered photographs of Brighton's first Pride. I'm here with Wayne at Sussex Beacon and we're here to talk a little bit about the new exhibition of some new photos. Could you talk to us a little bit about what the exhibition is about and how these photos came about?
Sure, well, I was contacted by a guy called Alf and he works for the Brighton Community Historic site, and they were looking through their old archives and they happened to come across some old pictures. Now these pictures had never been put into print before. They weren't shown in the newspaper or displayed anywhere else. And once they looked at them, they realized that they were pictures from a protest that happened in 1973, which was the first unofficial Pride in Brighton, and it's nice to be able to look at these photographs and see the roots of what it is. I mean, for us now, Pride can sometimes come across as a bit of a party and a bit of fun, and that's great, that's what it's about, it's about celebration. But it's nice to look back and remember that there was times when it was frightening to be homosexual, when it was you were putting your neck on the line to go out and protest. So to see these photographs of a group of 20 people walking down the streets holding placards in Brighton really does remind you of how far we've come, and that, you know, they were the trailblazers of where we are now.
Absolutely. I mean, I think it shows so much about the community back then, those photos. What does it show to you personally when you look at those images? Does it speak to you about the difficulties they've had to go through, the struggles they faced, or does it show you the strength of the community even then?
I think probably the strength of the community, and one of the things I really did pick up from them was that in the 70s Brighton was Brighton and they were still able to do this. This was before Stonewall, this was before the official Pride was announced in the 90s. So it's so lovely to be able to look back and know that there was people fighting for their rights and doing what they felt they should do. And if it wasn't for these people, especially the ones in Brighton doing what they've done, I wouldn't be able to be here and as open as I am, working for, you know, a brilliant charity and being myself. I've never had to hide who I am.
On a final note, I just wanted to ask what your favourite personal image is out there, if you've had a minute to. Is there one specifically that stands out, or yeah?
There is, really. So there's a little image out on the window which I absolutely love, and the protest had made its way down and they were on the seafront by this point. You can see a small group of about 20 people holding their placards, and there's a few old ladies sat in some deck chairs, some lovely old dears, and they're looking at the protest, almost in shock. But again, it's just a nice juxtaposition between what would have been a shocking thing and the everyday person witnessing it in Brighton at the time. So that's that lovely picture. Not only that, at the end there's another little old lady who's fast asleep and is totally unaware of what's going on, which I think is totally fabulous anyway. So yeah, that's got to be my favourite photograph.
Well, I mean, that really sums up. You've got the community, you've got the reaction, you've got the normality of the situation here in Brighton, really.
Definitely.
Of everyone coming together, however strange it might be.
That's it.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you.
It's been lovely to hear from you.
Thank you.
We'll go look at those images now.
Amazing. Right. Thank you.
Thank you so much.